Welcome to the Success Sensei Podcast for anyone interested in success, happiness, and balance. We'll teach you how to be a black belt at life. And now, your host, former professional fighter, multiple world champion, entrepreneur, and investor, Robert Devane.
Bowing in. This is Roundhouse, Rob the Success Sensei, helping you to win at life one kick and punch at a time. Episode 88. And it's the Friday Blitz.
The Success Sensei Friday Blitz coming at ya.
Who would you like to beat up? Now there's a Friday Blitz question for you. Who would you like to beat up? Did a name or a face flash into your mind? If it did, shame on you. You should be so much focused on your own goals and your own path that you don't have the time, the energy, the inclination, or the motivation to want to beat somebody else. So you should not have given anyone else that level of control over you to have given you the urge to want to beat them up, because then technically they've won as well. They've managed to evoke such an emotional response in you. They have affected you. They do have a hold over you because you want to beat them up. Now, if something else happened to them, like someone else beat them up or an accident happened to them, then yeah, you don't have to shed any tears. But for you to actually take time out of your life to actually want to beat somebody up, it's not necessarily a positive. You should be traveling so fast and so focused and so dedicated towards your own goal that the question is irrelevant. It's not an issue for you. I've been involved in combat sports, as you all know, because I'm sure you're all regular listeners. And if you're not, please listen to the back catalogue, because we're getting up there in the numbers, number 88. You know that I've been involved in combat sports for a long, long time. And yet, still to this day, it would be a very, very unique, very rare emotional response in me for me to want to give somebody a dig because they've annoyed me. That it's not really a response. Oh, I'd want to give someone a dig if I needed to defend myself. And I would most certainly want to give someone a punch or a kick if, you know, they were threatening myself or my family or anyone, anything like that. Yes. But not if it was just a disagreement or a differing of opinions or someone I just generally didn't like. Of course, I love everybody. I am the Success Sensei, and the Success Sensei loves everybody. That mightn't be entirely true, but the ones that I don't love and the ones that I extremely dislike, I don't hate to the point that I would like to beat them up. What is the point of that? Nothing good will come of that. It's whether you act on that level of emotion or not, nothing good is going to come. If you do actually make frustration and you transfer it into giving someone a punch or a kick, it's only going to go really bad from there, because you're going to feel bad afterwards, especially if it escalates. And that situation in and of itself may not be the end of it. It could be a vicious circle. You could end up having to fight more people, their family, their friends, the police, the courts, your own family, your own friends. So, you know, the actual physical route, if it's not defending yourself, what is the point? And so say you harbor those feelings of you would love to beat a certain person up, and you harbor those feelings but you never act on it. Again, what's the point of that? You're just wasting emotion. You're giving them a psychological hold over you. They're still, you've got feelings for that person. Yeah, they're not feelings of love, but listen to the way that's termed. You have feelings for them. Yeah, they're strong feelings of hate, but you're still tied to them with your feelings. It's like an ex, you know. People can really, really hate their ex-girlfriends or ex-boyfriends or ex-wives or ex-husbands, and they can really hate them. And the problem with that is hate is a strong emotion. It's still an emotion. So that means that you technically have emotions for your ex. Now that sounds horrible, doesn't it? It shouldn't be like that. You should get to yourself to the point, because it's destructive for you. Never mind for them. It's destructive for you to have those levels of feelings and still to be tied to those people emotionally. And it's exactly the same with people that you would like to beat up. You're tied to them emotionally. The best revenge is to live the best life you can live, to be happy and to succeed in the goals and the areas that interest you. That should be where all your time and all your energy and all your focus should go on. You shouldn't have time slots in your day to be able to fantasize about beating up people that you don't like or certain people. Just avoid them. There's that many people on the planet. There's that many really good people. I guarantee you don't even have enough time for the good people in your life. So please don't waste your time or your energy or your own frustration or your own mental health thinking about people that you don't like and imagining giving them a punch or a kick. Because if you do believe in karma, what goes around comes around, and they'll get theirs, they'll get their comeuppance anyway. So have faith in the process and stick to your own goals and stick to your own path. Thank you for listening. I'm Roundhouse Rob, the Success Sensei. Life is a fight you can enjoy and win. Bowing out.
This has been the Success Sensei, fighting the winning fight. So add us, subscribe, like, and comment. Keep those hands up and keep moving forward.